Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Today I have the Dell Precision 7960 workstation. This is Dell's current top-of-the-line workstation. It supports a single Intel Xeon W3400 series CPU with up to 56 cores, up to 4 terabytes of memory, and up to 4 GPUs with a bunch of options for storage. If you are interested in seeing more workstation and server reviews, consider subscribing to our channel, or give it the thumbs up if you like our videos. Let's dig in. This system does support similar specs to Lenovo's P7 workstation, which you can see here, and the HP Z8 Fury G5 workstation I did a few months back that you can also see here, or use one of those links in the description below. That said, none of those systems support the 4 terabytes of memory possible with this Dell Precision 7960 workstation. Yes on the 56 core processors, yes on the 4 GPU support, but so far a no on the 4 terabytes of DDR5 memory the Precision 7960 can deliver. It also comes in a 2U rack workstation version. In contrast, the Z8 Fury G5 supports up to 2 terabytes of memory, and the Lenovo P7 up to 1 terabyte, all DDR5. I suppose those capacities could change with a software update on the HP Z8 Fury G5 with 16 memory module slots on the system board, but not going to happen on the Lenovo P7 given only 8 memory module slots. That one might eventually get up to 2 terabytes. Like the other systems, this one does not have integrated graphics, so you will need at least one GPU to connect a monitor. There is a range of GPUs supported from both NVIDIA and AMD, with the NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada generation GPU and the AMD Radeon Pro W7900 at the top of the stack, respectively. Both support 48 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory. As I've already said a few things about NVIDIA's RTX 6000 Ada in prior videos, let's take a look at that AMD Radeon Pro W7900 GPU. On the performance side, it does rank a little below the RTX 6000 Ada and below the GeForce RTX 4090, but it still delivers some serious performance. Launched in April of 2023, the W7900 is for professionals and creators. It has the code name Plum Bonito, which I mention just because I find these code names so stupid. It features RDNA 3 architecture with 57,700 transistors compared to the 76,300 transistors on the RTX 6000 Ada, so that may explain to a certain extent the performance discrepancy, but also about $2,000 less, so there is that. It has 6,144 shading units, 384 texture mapping units, and 192 ropes, plus 96 ray tracing acceleration cores. There are 3 DisplayPort 2.1, plus a mini DisplayPort 2.1. It uses a PCI 4.0 interface just like all the other GPUs supported in the lineup. These same GPUs seem to be shared across all platforms from Dell, HP, and Lenovo. Are you interested in the Dell Precision 7960 workstation? If you are, for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information on this system, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video, itcreations.com. The front of the Dell 7960 definitely shares the same DNA as the previous generation 7920 workstation, just updated and more rounded. It is quite large. There is a panel at the bottom on the right with a slider lock that hides a media bay at the top with a slot for an optical drive, and then 4 flex bays below that. Those bays can be outfitted with SAS, SATA, or up to 4 NVMe M.2 drives. Each M.2 drive occupies a 3.5-inch carrier with a separate pop-out caddy that holds the drive, just like on the older version. There is still a handhold at the top, front, and back to carry this thing around. You know, just in case you want to take it to the gym or something. It is quite useful as fully loaded, the system can weigh in at over 82 pounds or 37 kilos. The control panel at the top of the system starts with a power on button, hard drive activity LED, universal audio port, dual USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, one USB Gen 2x2 Type-C port with PowerShare, then a USB Gen 2 Type-C port, with SD card slot below that. To the left, the plastic panel is generously perforated for airflow with 2 hidden fans top and bottom. On the back of the system, a very easy to remove power supply unit in the upper left. In this case, an 1100 watt to 1400 watt gold rated PSU. The other option is a platinum rated 1500 watt or 2200 watt PSU. But that all depends on your outlet. For standard outlets in North America at up to 120 volts AC, you get the lower wattage of 1100 watts. On the gold or 1500 watts on the platinum. However, with a 240 volt AC system like for a server room or an appliance outlet, say for your washing machine, you will get those higher output numbers of 1400 watts on the gold or 2200 watts on the platinum. There are 4 expansion card slots at the top and 4 at the bottom. In between are several ports, including an audio line out port, two old school PS2 ports for keyboard and mouse, a serial port, then two RJ45 ports with a 1 gigabit Ethernet port on top and a 10 gigabit Ethernet port on the bottom. Next, a column of three USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C ports, and beside those, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports and a single USB 3.2 Gen 1 port with a smartphone charging capability. I think we all need that. The panel to the left can be configured just like the flex bays up front with up to four 3.5-inch drive carriers for SATA, SAS, or NVMe M.2 drive carriers. This system is also Wi-Fi and Bluetooth compatible via the integrated Qualcomm WCN6856-DBS module. The side panel has an optional lock with perforations towards the rear for airflow to the PCI slots top and bottom. Once removed, we can see there is a large plastic baffle with integrated fans covering the CPU and memory module slots. A large fan is integrated with the PCI retainer's top and bottom. There are clear thermal zones with the installed plastic baffle keeping the heated air from the CPU and memory module slots separate from the PCI lanes where two GPUs would be installed on top and two on the bottom in a fully loaded configuration. There are a few NVMe connectors for the optional rear-mounted NVMe drives in the lower right-hand corner of the system board. Additional connectors are found on the other side of the system board with two NVMe connectors for the front-mounted FlexBay drives at the top and two SATA connectors for installing SATA drives in the rear drive cage at the bottom of the board. Each NVMe connector can handle two drives, while the SATA connectors can handle up to four drives apiece. VROC, or virtual RAID on CPU, is supported across up to 8 SATA ports, offering RAIDs of 0, 1, 5, or 10, depending on if you install the standard or premium key. The integrated Intel chipset controller can also support up to 8 M.2 drives in the four external flex bays, or up to 8 M.2 drives with two Dell UltraSpeed Drive Quad by 16 PCI cards installed. The Dell UltraSpeed Duo card option can support two M.2 drives and will take up a by 8 PCI slot. You can get a maximum of four drives per RAID set with four drives front and four drives in the rear. For other RAID options and to support SAS drives, you can install an optional Mega RAID 9660 or 9540 hardware RAID controller, also offering RAIDs of 0, 1, 5, or 10. Let's see how storage on the system plays out at full capacity, or fully loaded. Dell says this system can be outfitted with up to 152 terabytes of storage. There are three basic full capacity configurations: 8 drives with 4 in front and 4 in back, plus the optical drive; 10 drives with 6 in front and 4 in back with no optical drive or media bay, as that would now have a 2-bay drive cage. Lastly, an 8 M.2 drive configuration, again with 4 in front and 4 in back. Of course, there is the mix and match option too. With Dell's Precision 7960, there are no capacity limitations on the drives like some of the other manufacturers for those front flex bays. However, listed capacities for those drives at time of publication are still at up to 4 terabytes for M.2 drives and up to 12 terabytes for SATA or SAS options. In a nutshell, that 10 drive option will provide the most storage, assuming 10 drives at 12 terabytes for 120 terabytes, and then pop in two Dell UltraSpeed Drive Quad by 16 PCI cards, plus a Mega RAID controller card for 32 terabytes more for 152 terabytes total. Only 96 terabytes with the 8-bay 3.5-inch option with an added controller, plus three quad PCI cards and a duo card for up to 144 terabytes. Lastly, that fully M.2 option will get you 36 terabytes with front and back M.2 drives, then 44 terabytes more, assuming we add another controller and a few of the quad and duo PCI cards, at up to 88 terabytes, more or less. Still, you will need a slot for a GPU to run a monitor or two, and thankfully there are 8 PCI slots on this platform. Dell did not skimp on the PCI slots. With up to 112 PCI 5.0 lanes supported by the Intel Xeon W3400 series processors, there are options for expansion and supporting NVMe drive options. The Intel W790 chipset also delivers up to 16 PCI Gen 4 lanes. You could call those bonus lanes for additional SSD support. PCIe slots include pretty much all PCI 4.0, with only 2x16 PCI 5.0 slots. Those would be the slots closest to the CPU top and bottom. Then there's two PCI 4.0x16 slots, two PCI 4.0x8 slots, and two more x8 slots that have a x4 link bandwidth. The connectors for the optional NVMe M.2 drive bays and the flex bays, front and back, are also PCI 4.0. Plenty of options to fill those slots with GPUs, extra storage, HD controllers, network controllers, and even a Thunderbolt 4 card for super fast data transfers. 16 memory module slots on the system board support registered or registered 3DS DDR5 ECC memory modules. At full capacity, the system can be outfitted with up to 4 terabytes of memory using 256 gigabyte memory modules in all slots. I don't know how many people would actually use all that memory, but nice to know it is there. If you don't need that much memory, you can just pop in a 16 gigabyte memory module and call it a day. Some people were quite upset that other similar platforms were not utilizing the full potential of the supported technology, and honestly, I can't blame them. Dell, on the other hand, has not limited the CPU cores nor memory support. Chuck Norris would approve. There are a bunch of software tools to diagnose your system in the event of some mishap, but let's not dwell on the potential problems. Instead, check out the Dell Optimizer for Precision. It's an AI-based optimization tool that analyzes your work habits to optimize performance. The Precision 7960 also features independent software vendor certification, or ISV, for a number of popular software applications. It's compatible with both Windows and Linux operating systems. I will mention that starting the first quarter of this year, that is 2024, Microsoft will be insisting their Windows operating system is installed on an SSD. No HDDs allowed. With the Intel Xeon W3400 series CPUs, memory speeds of up to 4800 megatransfers per second are supported, although some CPUs will only support memory speeds of 4400 megahertz, and you may also reduce memory speed with 2 DIMMs per channel in some configurations. Options for the CPU itself include those with 12 cores at the low end with the Intel Xeon W5-3423 to 56 cores with the W9-3495X CPU installed. That one also has a TDP of 350 watts and a base clock speed of 1.9 gigahertz boosting to 4.8 gigahertz plus a 105 megabyte cache. All of them feature Intel's hyper-threading technology for twice the number of virtual cores compared to physical cores. Although, again, I will mention that cores are not everything, and it really depends on the workload for deciding on whether more cores are better or less cores. I do hope you like the hardware overview of the Dell Precision 7960 workstation. I mean, out of all the new workstations out there, this one definitely has dibs on memory support at up to 4 terabytes. Also impressive GPU support. Why the air quotes on new, you might ask? This is the internet, after all, in 2024. Who really knows how long this video will exist in the ether, and technology never ages well. There are still a few more Dell Precision platforms we need to review, so subscribe to our channel to get a notification when we release a new video. If you have any questions, post them in the comment section below. I did add a few links to some other Dell and other workstations we've already reviewed, plus a link to IT Creations for more information on this platform. You can also use one of those links right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.